Hi guys, Frostfangs here, and welcome back once again, of course, to another Paladins video. We are going to be playing some Torvald today. You knew it from the title. It's been a couple months since I made a Torvald video. I think it was in September, maybe even before then. It's been a little while. I think the last time I played him was straight after he got the change that kind of put him in the ground a little bit more than I kind of expected it to, and I think most people would probably agree with me on that. The Torvald's play rate has been really, really low recently, from my experience and from what you guys have been telling me in the comments. That seems to be the case. I think originally, when I made the video around Torvald's change, I wasn't expecting it to really make that big of a difference because he'd already been nerfed a couple times in the past and it didn't really affect his play rate. He stopped being picked up as much in like the higher tiered things, and obviously I'm not really talking about ranked specifically with this. I'm much more leaning towards casual because more people play casual than play ranked. But as far as I know, he has dropped off also pretty significantly in ranked. He's still seen every now and again the same way he is in casual, but he's definitely dropped off. When you actually look at the changes he's had over the last couple patches, they don't seem too crazy from the outside, but if you've been playing Torvald really regularly, it's just the sort of thing that you'll really massively feel. Field study, for example, got cut literally in half from 30% buff to 15%, so it's the same as Genos. The difference is with Torvald, when you throw the mark on somebody, it's for what, like 2 seconds? Let me hit advance. I think it's 2 seconds, possibly three. Yeah, it's 3 seconds. Okay, I was close. And you can extend it with the other talent to two, but obviously if you're picking field study, it's 3 seconds, whereas with Genos, it's like 10, and you can buff it out to be like 12, whereas with Torvald, you have no way to even buff out the duration. You can reduce the cooldown. You are, I guess, throwing it out more often, but it is a 3 second damage buff for 15%. It's definitely nowhere near as much as it was. Threat Current is a talent that doesn't really have a place. It's not a very strong talent. It does work in some situations, but overall, it is definitely like bottom of the barrel, I would say, talent-wise. I know some of you guys use it. If you do well with it, then that's whatever, but I think overall, a Direct Current doesn't perform very well, and with Thanks Grandpa, it's kind of the common one that I'm seeing now over Field Study, and that is obviously because Field Study got pulled down by half, although Thanks Grandpa did actually used to have a CC immunity, if you remember, which I think was also probably a little bit too strong. Torvald has bounced from being really, really good at kind of underperforming a little bit, like multiple times, and now he's in that little phase where he's a little bit under, I think, where he probably should be. I'd actually say overall he's in a kind of similar position to Rahm, where in the really low stuff, I think Torvald does quite well, and as soon as you get to like middle and high, he really does fall off quite quickly. And I really want to see some cool stuff done with Torvald. I hope that in the future they do end up doing cool things with him. They've talked about it, I think, before. I've seen a couple things where they were talking about changing Torvald. But basically what I'm doing with Torvald in today's video, which is taking me ages to actually get to because I had a bit of explanation I wanted to do just there at the start, for some reason we're going to be playing him once with the standard setup, the one that you see all the time: movement speed, cooldown reduction, reset, and then these two cards level one. This is like the most standard loadout of any character ever. Basically, whenever I see Torvald played, it is with this loadout. I say that with a couple other characters, but with Torvald is more true than I think with anybody else. And then I have two other versions here, which I might try in a match. If we do three, I'll play one with each. Both of the loadouts are very, very similar to the standard one you see with Torvald, but instead I'm changing out the leveling a little bit and adding in a different card instead of the 100 shielding whenever you use your Q. This one increases your ammo by 5 for, I guess, as close as you can get to damage a Torvald without going for nullify, which I wouldn't usually recommend. This puts our ammo from 15 to 20, and then this one is reducing the cooldown of our right click from, I think, 12 to 7. Is it 12 seconds? How long is the cooldown is right click? It's 12. Okay, yeah, so it's going from 12 to 7. I'd say Torvald doesn't really have too hard of a time with Rahm, but at the same time, it kind of goes both ways. To his benefit, it's really, really easy to land your shots on Rahm. You can pull him out of his F with the silence, which should be really, really strong. You can provide shielding to your teammates, but at the same time, Rahm has a literal minigun and can pick up Wrecker to shred through shielding pretty quick, and he also has an ultimate which clears shields, which, as far as I know, pulls the shield off of Torvald. I don't know for 100% sure because I haven't actually played Rahm against Torvald or seen a Torvald and Rahm in the same game, so I'm actually not sure, but considering the way this is described, I would imagine it would go through shields because it destroys shield and Torvald has a shield on him. But at the same time, I will say if they're on the same team together, they probably synergize quite well. We'll go ahead and lock him in. We'll use a battle pass booster for the boys. We've got Siege Stonekeep as the map. We've got Strix, we've got a Willow. We're looking like we're going to have a Genos as well. Genos and Torv do come up quite well. I imagine if we both go for damage buff, we might be in a pretty good situation. It looks like we're actually going to have a really interesting setup here on our side. We've got a Rahm, which was the synergy I was talking about earlier. Hopefully this does work out quite well. And we've also got a Genos. This is a really good situation for Rahm to be in because he's getting healed, he's getting shielded, he's getting damage buff, he's getting speed buff. This is really good for him, actually. But I gotta say, as much as I'm wanting Torvald to be changed, I'm also really looking forward to playing these matches today. We're up against Term, an Eevee, a BK, a Furia, and a Victor. Okay, Victor's going to give us a little bit of trouble. BK as well, kind of, but Eevee, Furia, and Term aren't too bad. I reckon Field Study probably makes the most sense here, but Direct Current could also be useful, and I probably should go for the standard loadout for the first match, but at the same time, that silence could really help us because I can use it on Eevee and the Victor, and also the Term to kind of silence them and maybe help us out. Should we go for the standard one, or should I go for this first? I feel weird going for that first. Should we go for the tryhard loadout first? Yeah, sure, we'll go for the standard one, and then we'll go for the variations after that. He is going for resilience, so it kind of doesn't really make sense for me to go for the silence-focused one. We'll start out with Kronos, even though it doesn't make a massive amount of sense. I mainly want to grab it so we can use that silence more if we need to. It's my first game today, so I'm not expecting to do too well. There's a shield on the Willow. Get some more little cheeky shots. I regen our thing real quick because I got my health taken down really fast. How are you reloading already? You have 500 ammo. You literally just started the round. There's a shield for Willow as she tries to run away. Get a silence on him. I can silence him through his shield. I actually didn't know that. I have not played Torvald in a while. There's a shield for him. Go ahead and pop our F and just avoid as much as we can. Get some little dinks into him. Throw a shield on him if I can. There we go. That was awkward. There's a Q on him. Hello, Term. I was going to call you Torvald then, but that's me. Some shots on him. Let's go ahead and regen. I think shield you. Actually like the fact that I can throw my Q out whilst I regen my stuff. There's characters that have weird interactions. Luckily, that isn't one of them. Honestly, thought we were going to lose that team fight, but we managed to regain it. Strix is having quite a tough time at the back. Rom is pushing up front. I went ahead and shielded him there. He is getting it freaking cleared pretty quick. Didn't go through talents, but we've got Luminary, Enforcer Blast, Fire, Crack Shot, Decimation, Wormhole, Royal Subjects Burst Mode, and Cherish. Very, very standard stuff, so I'm glad I went for the standard setup. It's definitely the one that makes the most sense. There's a Q on him. Hello, Term. There's a silence for you. I've got Resilience once. That's already pretty damn short in comparison to what I'm used to. The three-man stun from Fury. I can't even be mad at that, but I think we've got the... Yeah, we've got the cap. Okay, there's a Q for you. There's an F, and there we go. I don't really know what the plan is. We're kind of making a push, but the team's getting harassed a little bit by Eevee. I'm just waiting to be able to regen my shield. There we go. Shield the ROM. There we go. Okay, he's actually out of there. Used his F. That's the BKQ. This is really stressful. This is a really tense match for the freaking first round. I'm thinking of maybe going to the right and trying to ult people off. The point is being contested. BK is up there. There's a Q on you. Fury is gone. Nice flank. Freaking Torvald, boys. That's what's going on. Can I get a silence through to you? There we go. Okay, it just didn't work. That's a new icon that I'm not used to seeing. That's the Term ult icon. I've never seen that before. Why is that the first time I'm experiencing that? I don't think it was hot fixed in. That was a weird desync there, but okay, sure. I managed to get the push. 2-0, 5 minutes. Not really sure what I should go for item-wise. We've got caught on Rom, caught on Willow, caught on the Strix already maxed out, which is nice. Janos is going for Blast, Shield, Resilience, and Kronos. I've got Kronos. I've got 300 crates as well, though, so I'm not sure what to grab. Do I grab Resilience? I don't really feel like I need CC reduction, but maybe I should. I guess I can just go for Blast Shields. That's a really safe pick. Oh, Rom said controls are annoying, so just be glad you ain't playing against Akana or Janos. Yeah, he gets freaking screwed pretty damn hard by those two. They're pretty direct counters to him. That's Rom running in aggressively. We might be able to kill the BK here. These guys are both not looking too great. Well, there's a shield for him. We're making a pretty aggressive push. Strix just killed the Victor. Willow just killed the BK. There's a Q on you. Can I get a silence on this Eevee? Never mind, she's just dead. I thought we were going to have at least a little bit of trouble there. The team played super aggressively and that really paid off. BK is going to bomb me, but that's fine. There is my F. Guess making our shielding stat look good. There we go. That's the Term icon again, which doesn't display properly through walls just like the rest of them. Although, for some reason, I've never seen the Term one before. It's like my first time seeing it. Go ahead and shield the Rom as he runs in. Maybe we can kill the Furia. Nice. There we go. I had to dinker a couple times there. Strix landed a shot. He's doing a really good job so far. We'll just keep pushing this point. There's my F. Let's go push in here. Maybe we can get these guys out. Hello, Term. What's popping? It's flank goddamn Torvald again. There's a thingy on you. There's a silence on Eevee. Strix is doing mad work damage-wise so far. I'm trying to buff him out. The Jones is buffing him out. There was a silence on Eevee. She is very close to being gone. Let's just pop the ult and secure this. There we go. This should make sure that we don't miss it. Term is just doing a really, really high slam dunk F, and there's the 4-0 victory. That was a really strange siege game. It felt even right at the start, and then we just kind of started to steamroll. Strix did a really good job on damage, so I'm glad to see he's got the top play. Let's go ahead and see what it is. I don't remember him getting a triple or a quad or anything, so let's see. So he lands a shot on the EV. Pistol switches, but it doesn't actually use it. He goes ahead and lands a shot on the Fury. Lands a shot on the Term as well. Lands, I think, one more. Yeah, there we go. Somehow threaded that through, and then I think that's the end of it. Maybe he kills the other two guys as well. Good play nonetheless. Well, there we go. There are the stats for game one. Shout outs to TQ Zax, I'm guessing is how you say that. Although Benito is complaining about Fear because she only has 30k heals and stuff, which isn't terrible. And then TQ Zax said, Max Speed Torvald is epic. GG. Shout outs to him. That was the enemy Eevee. I kind of want to title the video that now, but at the same time, it wouldn't really make sense considering Max Speed Torvald is like the standard way of playing Torvald. But if we go through the stats, Rom did fine. Jones did pretty damn good. So I did the Strix. Shout outs to these two guys. They both shredded. So did Will, just a little bit less. We did pretty good though. 7-3, 110 seconds on the point. Was objective boy there. We had an okay amount of damage, but I didn't really get a chance to do very much because I was mostly just focusing on shielding, which did kind of pay off. 80k isn't too bad. BK definitely played the best on their side. He did go for a Wrecker. Term did a little bit under average. So did Furia. So did the Victor. And so did the Eevee. I feel like overall we just had the more, I guess, consistent and put together team. Nobody in that match really played badly though. Nobody bombed or anything. We'll go ahead and queue for another siege or an onslaught. Sure, I don't want to do TDM with Torvald, so we'll just queue for these two. All right, well, it looks like for game two, we've got Siege Bazaar. We've got a Lian and an Eevee already locked in. Shout outs to Kokioto, like the name, that is the Lian. Hopefully she does well. Honestly, kind of enjoyed playing Torvald there. I didn't feel like I had that big of an impact, but I did feel like I was helping out the team. So I didn't feel like I was impacting the enemy team. I felt like I was impacting ours more than anything else. We've got Torvald, we've got a Ying as the last two lock ins, and let's see what we're up against. We're just waiting on that one last pick. Siege Bazaar, I imagine, is not the best map for Torvald, but it also isn't the worst. We're up against Damba, Aram, a Pipstrix, and Maeve. So this will be interesting because we've got an Atlas on our side this time instead of Aram, and then we're up against a solo tank. Aram, I might actually go for the Silence one here. I think we'll go for Field Study again, probably makes the most sense, but then we'll go for this one instead. Sure, I haven't played with this before, but having the Silence up a little bit more often should help with Aram, especially since he is going for Enforcer, although he isn't really going for an Enforcer loadout, he's going for a right-click loadout, but he is still going for the talent, I guess. We got Deja Vu on Atlas, we got Snow Globe on Eevee, Eminence, Life Exchange, Catalyst, Cat Burglar, Crackshot, Enforcer, and Spirits Chosen. I'm actually kind of surprised he's not going for the other talent. It probably works out quite a bit better because it does clear shields and stuff. I didn't buy items, but that's fine. I can do that in a minute. I completely freaking forgot. That's just the most newbie thing I've done in a video in ages. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. Hello, Ram. There's a silence on you. That clearly surprised you. I don't think you were really expecting that. It also stops him from using his Q and shit, so he is actually probably dead here. There we go. I think that silence really threw him off, and it's got a super short cooldown with reset. For some reason, this skin feels smoother than the one I was just playing. I actually think I prefer this a lot. There's a silence on Dan, but oh, he's so low. Atlas, please, please. There's my F. I died to Strix. Can somebody just tickle that Dan? He's got like no health. Thank you, Leanne. I'll go ahead and buy my Kronos and just pretend like that never happened. Eevee just got rid of the Zin. I think we've got a pretty favorable matchup here overall. Atlas and freaking Torv versus Rom definitely screws him over a decent amount. What is my play here? Let's shield you. Well, Rom just got rewound. There's a Q on Eevee. Nice. Let's get some little dinks up there on Maeve. Objective captured. Yeah, this skin seems like it runs at like a higher frame rate than the other one. I can see my shots way clearer, so I'm definitely going to be using this one in the future. There goes the Strix. Oh, I'm trying to get to you, Eevee, but you're dead. It looked like she was in her ice block there, but she's still died. Not really sure what happened. This Damba is trying to run away. I can't kill him because he just got healed by Pip. Strix is over there at the back. There's some dinks on you, Damba. That stun is really sucky. Okay, that nearly got me killed. There's a shield. I think Strix is up there, or where is he? I'm not sure. Eevee's going in on him. I think she just killed him, and then she died. Okay, sure. Pepper is just here. There's some little dinks. I don't have any cauterize, which sucks, and I also can't land those shots because you're moving too fast. Hello, Ram. What's popping? I'm not really sure what you're going for here. That's the Strix going for the blind. I'm going to regen my shield. That is Damba fearing me. My god, that's a weird perspective there. There's a Q on her. Ram is probably going to run in. There's a silence, and there's also a goddamn rewind for him. For some reason, my silence doesn't disconnect whenever he gets rewound. That's weird. Tried to get around the corner. Died beforehand. Goddamn. Am I the only person who died there? Oh, Alice died too. Okay. Went ahead and grabbed a little bit of Haven. That should help us out a bit. There's a silence on the Ram. Cool. I'm just going to hold him here for as long as I can. There's a Q on the Atlas. He's going for the ult. Sure, he did technically just kill the Eevee, but he is going to die for it. There's a shield on you. Cool. There's a silence on the Pepper. I tried to stop her from using the thing. Maeve died too. Leanne. Nice. She's being rewound. I freaking predicted exactly where she was going to go. Totally didn't just mess that up. Well, it's looking pretty good for us. I could ult here if I need to, but I think we might be fine. I'm just going to go for the ult. That should secure the push, right? That should do it. Oh, no. He's going to run in. I just used my F. There's a silence that was a little bit late. Sure. That is the rewind. I'm not really sure what the play is, but we're nearly getting the push. Is he actually in range there? That's annoying. Strix is behind me. So is the Maeve. I made a pretty damn awkward play there. I used my ult and really thought we were going to get that. I'm not sure how they were able to hold it. Eevee is playing absolutely hectic from what I just saw. She did die though, sadly. And there is the push failed. All right. 1-1, 5 minutes. We probably could have got that if I played that a bit better. I feel dumb for the way I played there. Went ahead and grabbed Haven too. Probably going to get Resilience and Cauterize as my other two items because we could probably do with more Cauterize. Eevee is going for Morale Boost, which does kind of make sense because she's going for Snow Globe. She's doing a pretty damn good job. I feel like I just need to kind of step my game up a little bit. I've been playing kind of ass so far. Let's just get some dinks into him. What is the play here? I'm not really sure. He's trying to use his run. He got freaking banished. I was trying to silence him, but sure, banish works too. Hello, Maeve. You're banished as well. I feel like me and Atlas are kind of counting each other a little bit here, but there is the attempted silence before she dashed away because I think I got out of range. That is Pep going for the ult. Pep, yes, that's a mix between Pip and Pepper. I actually got freaking caught in that, and I'm somehow still alive. I am making such awkward plays today. Just going to keep hitting into him. There's a silence, so you can't run away. Just cancel it early and keep shooting him. Nice. Feel like going for the silence freaking loadout was not actually a bad idea. We got rid of the freaking Strix, and then I died. Atlas used his rewind. That was a rhyme. Leon is going for the ult. She hit the Damba. He's nearly gone. I'm going to go ahead and get a little bit of resilience. For some reason, I have to click that like 5 times. Well, it looks like we're going to get the cap again. He got rewound, so he doesn't have his F up. He is just dead. Me and Atlas are working well together, but also countering each other. And I feel like that's just the nature of the two characters. They synergize, but at the same time, they also kind of screw each other over. Atlas does that just in general with nearly every character because of just the way he is. I think I might just start calling Pip slash Pepper Pep. Whenever I see a Pip or a Pepper in the game, I think I might just go ahead and call them Pep because that way I'm wrong all the time, but I'm also technically right all the time. Let's go ahead and throw a Q on him. Rewind came through clutch there. All right, couldn't even tell where he goddamn came from. Some more little shots. We'll throw a shield on the Atlas. I think we can probably make this push just considering Ying is ulting. I'm spamming my right click, but they're out of range. There's a Q on him again. I think we can probably kill that Strix. Yep, there we go. He's gone. Maeve is really low as well. This is probably going to be a team wipe. I reckon we got the push this time around. I landed the silence, so he's just going to have to sit here and wait. He's going for the ult. I jigged a little bit bit left and right there, so I couldn't get out of it, but that's fine. He's probably still dead. There's the rewind. Wish he did that a little bit earlier, but it's fine because he is still gone. Threw a shield over on the Leon kind of accidentally, but she just got freaking bursted by the Strix. The blind just got countered. Well done, Atlas. That is the Maeve blind. I'm just going to try and blast him away and see if we can get the push. There we go. It's unnecessary, but I guess they used a Maeve ult for it, so I used a 12 ult for it. It's only even. There we go. 3-1. You can definitely chuck that on my top 20 list of most unnecessary ults, but it technically got it, and for some reason, now the freaking spawn barrier doesn't show. I guess it's because we got the cap when Maeve was ulting, so I don't see this. For some reason, Maeve blind gets rid of the spawn barriers. We got Resilience 2 now. We've also got a little bit of cauterize. The Atlas has finished off Resilience. Even Resilience 1 was helping me out in that last round, especially with the Damba stun and the Pepper ult and the Rahm ult. Rahm's Wrecker is screwing me over a little bit. My shields don't feel anywhere near as strong. That's definitely a big downside to Torvald, and that's anywhere you play him, is that he gets countered massively by Wrecker. There goes Pip slash Pepper. Leanne just got a double. Ying is over there, I think, against Maeve. Seems like she's actually still up. There's the victory. I forgot it was 3-1. I thought it was 2-2 for some reason. There we go. Another really, really weirdly easy win. And it looks like Damage has the top play. Again, it's Leanne. So she gets rid of the Rahm. No, never mind. He does actually run away instead. She gets rid of the Strix, landing a double Q. She gets a kill on the Pepper, and then she gets an assist on the Damba. Wonder why that was chosen as top player. Even I feel like there were better plays than that, but it was technically an unofficial triple, right? And there you go. There are the stats for game two. Basically the same thing that we had in the first game. Not really a crazy stat other than the shielding, which is decent. 65k damage is significantly below average, and our objective time is okay overall. I did pretty mediocre considering the situation. Eevee, I did really good. So did Leon. Shouts to those two guys. They shredded. Atlas also did a good job. I feel like I would have actually done better if he was on a different tank, because Atlas was kind of screwing me up a little bit, but not because he was really going for it. It's just the way Atlas works with Torvald. I'd say Ying also did a really, really good job on their side. Strix and Pip and also the Rahm were all around the same sort of thing on like the average for the match, I guess. And then Damba was a bit above that maybe. And Maeve was probably a little bit under that because she only has 20k, which is half of a Torvald damage nearly. Could do another match, but honestly, we just did two siege matches and I feel fine leaving it here. I feel like I've got everything out I wanted to get out for Torvald, and I feel like I did a pretty good job of showing off the spot he's in. He's not in a terrible spot. He could be much worse, but he also could be so much better. And I feel like he is a little bit below the rest of the pack. And I think they're aware of that too, just from what I've been hearing. He's definitely still playable. He's got his upsides, but he also just has a ton of downsides, and especially with his talent choice, I think that's the weakest point. None of them really feel like they make that big of a difference. None of them would really affect the outcome of a game. And I feel like that kind of defeats the point of the talent system when so many other characters have like game-changing talents. Torvalds are just all kind of meh. As for like his cards and stuff, the one loadout that you see everybody playing with is a good loadout. You reduce the cooldown, you get movement speed and a reset and stuff. It's not bad. And I guess the other version that we just played with also isn't terrible because you get your nullify up more often, but he just has such a crappy selection of cards. Like there's so many of these that you just never would really go for. This one is particularly funny to me. Induction, it gives you ammo when you use your F, and it has a 5-second internal timer for some reason. The ability has 15 seconds. Yeah, you could technically kill like two or three people and fully reset it, and you can reduce the cooldown by 2.5, but what is the point in putting an internal timer on a possible 10 ammo you can regen on a 15-second ability that, yeah, you could technically reset, but why has it got a 5-second internal timer? I honestly don't know. So yeah, to summarize, I'm really excited to see where they take Torvald in the future, because I don't really feel like a buff or a nerf would really fix the problem. I feel like he much more needs like a rework with his cards slash his talents and stuff, but I don't really know. We'll see where he goes in the future. I'm excited to see it, and I'd say currently, just like everybody already kind of knows, he's a little bit under where I think he should be. Thank you for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Of course, let me know your thoughts on Torvald in the comment section down below. Also, let me know what you want to see me do next. I'll see you guys all really, really soon, and as always, stay frosty.